remarks are going to kick off. Our first speaker today is Esmeralda from BPNC.
Hello, good evening. I'm here today because there is an urgent need for minimum wage to go up. Many people can't make a living with $8.25, which is the state minimum wage. Many people in my community are losing their homes. Hoy estoy aquí para que suba el salario de mínimo. Mucha gente no puede vivir de 8.25. Y en la comunidad de Bryant Park, muchas de las familias viven con 8.25 y no pueden ir para pagar su casa aquí. Buenas tardes.
Minimum wage for tip workers. Anyone? $2.19. Could you live off that?
No!
Can you live off that?
No!
What do we need?
Higher wages!
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna meet with the rest of the marches. There are two other big marches that we're gonna meet in front of the Chamber of Commerce. We're gonna join the rest of the workers to demand an increase in the minimum wage!
Yeah!
So,
today, want to be witnesses to the Chamber of Commerce. Can you survive on 825?
No!
Illinois voters support a raise in the minimum wage. Because a raise in the minimum wage would create 20 million jobs for us. And it would stimulate the economy. And it would put money in the pockets of people like us who are going to go to the grocery store and to buy shoes for the kids when they go back to school and their backpacks. They need to raise the minimum wage.
Income and inequality has turned that achievement gap into an achievement gulf. Raising the minimum wage is one of the best ways to immediately help thousands of CPS students living in poverty reach their academic potential. The minimum wage issue is an educational issue. The Chicago Teachers Union supports raising the minimum wage here in Illinois so that our students can have a better future.
We've heard that two-thirds of the corporations doing business in our state don't pay any taxes to the state of Illinois. Could this be true? I hope the Chamber joins us very soon in supporting SB 282 so the citizens of Illinois can be sure that all publicly traded corporations who do business in our state are contributing their fair share for the resources they use and the services that contribute to keep our state healthy. Roads and bridges, education, public safety, services for seniors, and for our most vulnerable children. Look, we're here today, we're out in the sun, we could be doing a million different things, but we're right here tonight fighting to improve our communities and the lives of our neighbors in Chicago and across the state. Now it's time for the Chamber to encourage their members to be good corporate citizens too, to encourage their members to support a higher minimum wage so their employees can support their families, and encourage them to be transparent with the people of Illinois about how much they contribute to the common good, and yes, to pay their fair share in taxes. Thank you very much.
Of people who profit by exploiting us.
825 is not enough. We are demanding the minimum wage to go at least $10. And you know what? Increasing minimum wage is also good for the economy. These solar people, they lie to us every day. They say we cannot afford. We can afford. We can afford wars. We can afford the bailouts with our own money. But that's why I'm saying, stand up and get united together. Together we can make the difference.